welcome. Thank you for coming out in this horrible, horrible weather on a Friday night. My name is Rose Guccione, and I am a graduate student in vocal pedagogy here at Northeastern Illinois University. Although I was born and raised in Chicago, I did not have much exposure to musical theater. My professional background is largely that of an opera singer. As an educator, however, I feel it is important for me to at least be able to describe and give a demonstration as to how to sing contemporary commercial music, thus the choice for my thesis topic. Tonight, accompanied by Maestro Paul Dykstra, I will be presenting a lecture performance on Vakai Practical Method of Singing, a framework for teaching musical theater singers in the age of contemporary commercial music. The goal of this evening is to introduce Vakai, his didactic work for voice, and draw a connection to this work and its relevance in the training of contemporary commercial music, or CCM, within musical theater, or MT. Poet, translator, singer, voice teacher, composer, and academic administrator Nicola Vakai was born in Tolentino, Italy on March 15, 1790. Vakai's contemporary, composer Gioachino Rossini, is on record as having stated that Vakai was an expert on the physiology of the human voice. Oh, I should be clicking this, shouldn't I? Yeah. Okay. So there's Vakai. He's kind of handsome. I would have his baby. Vakai's first love was poetry. In fact, of the four verse tragedies Vakai wrote, one, Manilo Capitolino, was performed by the theater company Riva e Borelli on the night of July 9, 1807 in Pesaro when Vakai was just 17 years old. Vakai translated two works, Giuseppe by Etienne Nicolas Mehun and La Passione by Bach, although it is unclear which passion. There it is, okay. Vakai was the youngest of three sons born to a family of doctors. Initially having agreed to study law in Rome, Vakai instead began studies with Giuseppe Giannacconi at the Accademia di Santa Cecilia in Rome. Vakai was particularly interested in voice and counterpoint. Vakai received his Diploma di Maestro from the Accademia in 1811. Vakai then moved to Naples, where he continued studies in composition with Giovanni Paisiello. Although Paisiello was president of the jury at the Naples Conservatory, he urged Vakai to study directly with him rather than attend the school. Vakai did just that from 1811 to 1814. Vakai composed 17 operas, 4 cantatas, 4 ballets, sacred music, including a Holy Week service and several motets, more than 100 chamber pieces, including ariete, notturni, arie, romanze, duets, instrumental music, and 3 didactic books, including the foundation of today's lecture, his Metodo Pratico di Canto Italiano per Camera Diviso in 15 Lezioni, Ossiano, Solfeggi Progressivi ed Elementari Sopra Parole di Metastasio, first published in 1832 by Boosey and Hawkes in London. This work will be referred to as Vakai's Method for the brevity's sake. In the preface to a biography of Vakai's life written by his son Giulio Girolamo Alessandro Biaggi, a former Vakai student at the Milan Conservatory, wrote as translated from the original Italian, Vakai's voice was not naturally beautiful, but his singing technique was so perfect that it was sheer pleasure listening to him. His voice was clear and spontaneous with an excellent continuous flow. His breathing was calm and unnoticed. His legato and portamento were faultless. His portamento did not drag. His head register was perfect. His phrasing was as polished as his diction. He never lapsed to exaggeration or mannerisms. The result was a powerful, pure, and classic style with lively, vivid, and expressive accentuation. Vakai's singing agreed with the Greek philosopher's definition, enjoyment of the soul. During his life, Vakai was much sought after as a voice teacher in the places he taught. These included Venetian High Society, Trieste, Frohsdorf near Wiener Neustadt, Stuttgart, where he was offered the position of Kapellmeister but turned it down to pursue operatic composition, Paris, and England. In his post as director of the Milan Conservatory from 1838 to 1844, he reorganized the study of singing, inaugurated opera performances among his students on the Neapolitan model, set up a new choir school, and enlarged the repertory to include the German classics. Vakai continued to compose and teach voice until his death on August 6, 1848. We are now going to do a smash cut to the other topic of this presentation, American musical theater and contemporary commercial music. Musical theater in America was born out of several European musical forms, the list of which begins with 18th century opera. Although the era beyond musical theater's, quote, golden age, unquote, roughly 1943 to 1965, now includes country, folk, gospel, jazz, operatic style, pop, rap, rhythm and blues, and rock. The student who intends to pursue a career in musical theater almost exclusively receives classical voice instruction at the college level. Contemporary commercial music is an umbrella term for non-classical music genres, including musical theater. It entered the printed lexicon in 2003. However, development of methods that would lead toward the formation of the term began as early as the 1970s with a few notable New York pedagogues. The National Association of Teachers of Singing, or NATS, began to publish a regular column about non-classical vocal pedagogy in the 1980s under the editorship of none other than Richard Miller, and in 2000, sponsored its first belting workshop. According to the NATS website, the following is a list of pedagogical characteristics of music theater singing. The pharyngeal region is similar to speech. The larynx is in the mid or high position. The mouth shape is horizontal in females. Most vowels have a brighter color that is created by the use of more chest register and or by altering the resonance to a brighter, more forward placement. In males, the brighter color is maintained since the vowels are not modified or covered as much as at the high passaggio. Rather, the speech approach to singing is maintained. Less resonance is used to enhance the speech approach to singing. The shape of the pharynx in speech is much more relaxed than the stretched pharynx required in classical singing. Vibrato is not always used or appropriate. Chest register is used more than head register in females. Tessitura of songs mostly resides in the speech range of the voice. In an apparent attempt to support the various styles of singing, NATS started its So You Want to Sing series in 2014. All books are published through Roman and Littlefield. Each published book's corresponding online resource is available at nats.org. Just look in the lower right-hand corner of the webpage. Two books are on pre-order for later this year and are indicated by an asterisk in the slide, or hopefully you all have a paper. I should have made sure of that. In the next slide, I will be drawing from the essay published in the 2014 book, So You Want to Sing Music Theater, and in the book published 4 years later, So You Want to Sing CCM, both by Scott McCoy. It is interesting to note that with the exception of a brief introductory paragraph, the articles are identical. In fact, a skim through previews through Google Books and Amazon reveal that the very same essays appear in the other publications listed here. except for the ones on pre-order. I don't know what they'll be. Moreover, chapter 2 in So You Want to Sing Rock and Roll reads, singing, music, theater, and voice science, as does every heading on every page in the chapter. That's an oops on the part of the editor, I must say. One conclusion from this replication of the essay in books about differing styles would be that the voice science remains the same for all styles listed here. Timbre is created by the combined effect of the sound produced by the vocal folds and the resonance provided by the vocal tract. The two configurations and modes are mode 1, aka TA dominant, chest mode, modal voice. In this mode, short, thick folds that come together with nearly square-shaped edges. High-frequency harmonics are relatively strong. Mode 1 tends to yield a much brighter and brassier sound than in mode 2. Mode 2, aka CT dominant, falsetto mode, loft voice. In this mode, longer, thinner folds that only make contact at the upper margins. The harmonics are weaker than in mode 1. Free resonance occurs when sound travels through a hollow space in the case of singers, the vocal tract, which consists of the pharynx or throat, oral cavity or mouth, and nasal cavity, nose. When this synchronization of the vocal tract and sound source occurs, the system is in resonance. Resonant frequencies or areas in which strong amplification occurs are called formants. Formants provide the specific amplification that changes the raw buzzing sound produced by the vocal folds into speech and singing. The vocal tract is capable of producing formants by ascending pitch. The first two, F1 and F2, are used to create vowels. Higher formants contribute to the overall timbre and individual characteristics of a voice. In some singers, especially those who train to sing in opera, formants 3 through 5 are clustered together to form a superformant, commonly called the singer's formant, which creates a ringing sound and enables a voice to be heard in a large theater without electronic amplification. Keeping the two previous slides about modes 1 and 2 together with formant 1 through 5, let's examine the next two slides. Nats, in its Journal of Singing, publishes an article from time to time called Nats Visits Ats. ATS refers to the American Academy of Teachers of Singing. In 2008, it published a pronouncement issued by ATS entitled In Support of Contemporary Commercial Music, Non-Classical Voice Pedagogy. From spectrographs made of Over the Moon from Rent and Renee Fleming singing song, I think I skipped something. From spectrographs made of excerpts sung by Idina Menzel of Over the Moon from Rent, and Renee Fleming singing Song to the Moon from Rusalka, the article outlined the following observations. In the CCM example, it states that in Menzel's example, quote, harmonics, as evidenced in the prominent horizontal lines running across the image, have significant amplitude at very high frequencies, extending to the maximum 10 kilohertz cycles per second, display range of this spectrogram. At times, an extraordinary 20 harmonics can be seen. Inharmonics are often visible between the harmonics, providing evidence of noise or roughness that is deliberately added to this tone. In spite of rapid enunciation of text, formant zones, evidenced by darker and lighter color of individual harmonics, are relatively indistinct. Vibrato is used sparingly, primarily as an added expressive device, as shown in the first sustained tone, unquote. In the example measuring Fleming's aria, these observations were made. Quote, acoustic energy is confined to a relatively narrow frequency range, rarely extending beyond 5,000 hertz. At most, 7 harmonics are strongly present within the sound. All overtones are harmonic, indicating a sound uncolored by noise or deliberate roughness. Formant zones are discernible through the changing amplitude of harmonics. Amplitude shifts in harmonics 1 through 3 are in response to vowel formants. Constant amplitude of harmonics in the 2500 to 3500 hertz range is in the response to the singer's formant. Vibrato, as evidenced by the wavy appearance of harmonics, is unvarying. Hopefully you can see that. The article concludes, quote, since there are significant and measurable acoustic differences between classical singing styles and popular singing styles, the Academy proposes that the techniques used to train singers in those styles should be tailored to the particular performing needs of the singer. Within the body of contemporary commercial music is musical theater. Within the body of musical theater is contemporary commercial music. The foreshadowing of CCM within MT occurred in the 1960 musical Bye Bye Birdie. In 1968, it officially staked its claim in Hair. The slide here shows just a few examples of the genres of CCM as it occurs in MT. You can see, hopefully, country, jazz, pop, rock. At this point in the lecture, I would like to acknowledge the generosity of Professor John Glenn Patton, who mailed a copy of Vakai's 1834 publication, which appended a appended Vocalizzi to the original 1832 publication. The photocopy was made for Patton on June 26, 1970 at the British Museum. Patton used it to publish his own edition of Vakai's method with G. Schirmer in 1974. I will be using images from the 1834 document throughout the lecture. This is the cover of Vakai's book. Notice the beautiful script, the bottom of the page where we see, quote, published by the author, unquote, the misspelling of the word boozy, and the year 1834, the date of the publication in the lower right-hand corner. Vakai's biography provides a backstory to the inspiration behind the publication, as translated from the Italian. After the celebrations for the coronation of the King William IV on September 8, 1831, Vakai accepted an invitation to give singing lessons to the two daughters of the Marquess of Hertford at Sudbourne Hall during the holiday. This was his sole task. The daughters were not fond of solfège. They merely repeated what Vakai sang beat by beat. Vakai had observed a similar opposition to the principles of singing in foreigners. This made him realize how useful it would be to compose a series of exercises in which the difficulties and the dryness of the rules were tempered by a well-adapted melody. This concept was the basis for the publishing of his Metodo. This is actually the preface that's within the 1834 publication, and I believe in subsequent publications up to present day. Vakai himself provides the reasons behind the method in its introduction. The Italian language. The mastery of singing in Italian language makes singing in other languages easier. Efficient vocalization. The method was devised to streamline the process of vocalization. It was created as a response to a need observed by Vakai in Germany, France, England, and Italy of those who wanted to learn how to sing for amusement. Articulation. Where traditional methods focused solely on vowels, Vakai chose poems by Metastasio to help foreign speakers to articulate the Italian language. Development and demonstration. Vaccai's method aspired to serve as a sort of development and demonstration to every other system. Although Vaccai's method is rooted in bel canto, it is directly relevant to the musical theater student. Vaccai acknowledged there were other preferences in singing. He wrote these exercises not for the operatic stage, but for people who wanted to entertain in their home and did not need the amplification that opera singing can produce. Arguably, musical theater singers would likely not perform in the Italian language. They may be called upon to learn an accent or dialect, however. Italian is the easiest among languages, including English, with which to introduce the International Phonetic Alphabet, or IPA, to students. This skill is an essential tool to notate and read preferred pronunciations of dialects within musical theater roles and to encourage a blended sound within choruses to aid in the clarity of text. Pietro Metastasio's poetry in Vaccai's method is as streamlined as the method itself. Vaccai's exercises condense components of vocal technique and should be utilized as a framework to teach music theory, sight singing, solfege, and the International Phonetic Alphabet. This method also provides a basis for learning different musical styles and a touchstone that may be revisited through the student's career. Now I would like to call Maestro up to the stage. We will now explore Vaccai's method and how it may be used as a resource in training singers of CCM and MT. Here is the sequence of how each exercise will be explored. We will see an exercise from the 1834 publication together with IPA and a translation to that exercise. We will hear librettist Pietro Metastasio's lyrics as set by Vaccai, whose first love, as we may recall, was poetry. The source of these lyrics have been published in a 1994 dissertation by Gunnar Forshvud from the University of Gothenburg, Department of Musicology, entitled Con lieve fiato, or in English, with light breath. Each exercise will be sung in the classical style. We will see a list after of MT songs using the very interval or rhythmic principle around which Vaccai composed his exercises, compiled from John Franceschina's 2015 book, Theory Through Musical Theater. Following the list will be a proposed way to use Vaccai's songs. I have used the online program in NoteFlight to show the original text in Vaccai's book, International Phonetic Alphabet Transcription, Solfege, and text from an MT piece that may be inserted in a phrase. One of the music theater songs that from that list will be sung in my attempt at a contemporary commercial music style. Please note that each exercise never goes above the staff. This first piece, Manca sollecita, is literally the scale. The lyrics are from Antonio Caldara's opera Demetrio. The key is of the scale is in C major, a good key to use with the beginning student. Vaccai introduces two accidentals, F sharp and B flat. The hyphenation of the text is intentionally not correct, as it was Vaccai's wish to have the singer focus on sustaining vowels.
Con lieve fiato.
Here is the list of MT pieces built around major or minor scales. Gypsy is one example. You'll never get away from me. Younger than springtime. Younger than springtime, is she? Or something like that. It's not my genre, sorry. A piece from Annie Get Your Gun, entitled There's No Business Like Show Business. Everything about it is appealing. So we have here the Italian, then the IPA, then the solfege, and then if you look on the third line, my attempt at trying to put it into a scale, which probably will change because this really isn't as effective as actually showing the scale as it's written in the musical piece. But hopefully you'll hear it in the piece. So, Annie Get Your Gun is a classic musical about the fictionalized life of sharpshooter Annie Oakley from songwriter Irving Berlin. The story. Annie Oakley and Frank Butler meet when she beats him in a sharpshooting contest at Buffalo Bill's Wild West show, and the two have to negotiate between their competitive sides and their blossoming love for each other. The musical debut on May 16, 1946 at the Imperial Theater with Ethel Merman as Annie. Merman reprised the role in 1966 at the Broadway Theater nearly 20 years later. In 1999, the musical was revived again with Bernadette Peters as Annie. Vacai's second piece is based on intervals of thirds. The lyrics from the opera Demetrio composed by Antonio Caldara. The introduction of complex meter is introduced. The piece is written in the key of F major. Fakai defines intervals as the difference between two notes as seen in the footnotes, or not seen. It's in the, now you won't see it, in the lower right-hand corner. As in the previous exercise, Fakai is economical in his use of text. Hyphenation here is incorrect. Range does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title, Salti di Terza. A reason for his incorrect hyphenation is that Fakai wanted to bring home the idea that a singer should sustain the vowels as long as possible before getting to consonants. Here are examples of MT pieces composed around intervals of the third. If I loved you, then there's a doe, a deer, a female deer, and then all that jazz, which is what we're going to be performing next. This slide is organized in the same way as the first of its type, the Italian, the IPA, the solfege, and my attempt at putting words from all that jazz in there. Chicago is the longest running American musical in Broadway history. Chicago is based on a 1926 play about actual criminals and features the work of legends John Kander, Fred Ebb, and Bob Fosse. The story: Roxy Hart is sent to prison for killing a man who tried to walk out on her. While in prison, she meets Velma Kelly, a big-time vaudeville star with twice as much blood on her hands. The two vie for the same lawyer, Billy Flynn, to help win their freedom and play the public from prison to help win fame for when they're finally free.
Shoes and all that
Salti di Quarta. Bacai's third piece is written around intervals of the fourth. The lyrics are from the opera Si Face, composed by Popora. The meter is 2-4. The piece is written in the key of G major. As in the previous exercise, Vakai is economical in his use of text. Hyphenation is now correct. Range does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title. Let's sing that. Here are examples of MT pieces composed around intervals of the fourth. Something familiar, something peculiar. That would be one. Comedy Tonight from A Funny Thing Happened in the Way to the Forum. Kiss Me Kate, another opening, another show. On My Own is one that we'll be doing next, and this is really a long list. Prisoners of Love, Prisoners of Love, and What Is This Feeling from Wicked, which I don't know. I know Wicked, I know about Wicked. I gotta learn a lot of things about musical theater. Okay. This slide is organized in the same way as the first of its type, the Italian, the IBA, the solfege, and me trying to put On My Own in there. Les Miserables is the epic song through 1987 Tony Award winner for Best Musical, and is based on the novel by French poet and writer Victor Hugo. The story, Jean Valjean, a French peasant and convicted thief, is freed from jail by a kind bishop and makes the most of the opportunity, changing his name and eventually becoming a factory owner and mayor. When Valjean's criminal past is resurrected and the chief of police, Javert, vows to bring him to justice, Valjean is forced to give up everything he has worked for and flee. Before doing so, he promises Fantine, a former worker on her deathbed, that he'll find and care for her daughter Cosette. Years later, Valjean has cared for Cosette as a father. Javert seeks him still, and the city of Paris is torn by revolutionaries. Political and personal stories become intertwined, and all are called to question their devotion to freedom, love, and justice.
In the river, in the dark.
Salti di quinta. Vacai's fourth piece is written around intervals of the fifth. This is the fourth, the lyrics are again from the opera Demetrio, composed by Caldara. The meter is in common time. The piece is written in the key of D major. As in the previous exercise, Vacai is economical in his use of text. Hyphenation here is correct. Range does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title, Salti di Quinta. Here are examples of MT pieces composed around intervals of the fifth. This slide is organized in the same way as the first of its type. I'm just a girl who can't say no. Without You, which is what we'll be singing. I don't know my junk, but I wish I did. That's basically my knowledge. I'm still learning, guys. Okay, so here is Avet Sua Vivere in just a second. This should look familiar to you by now. The slide is organized in the same way as the first of its type. Rent is Jonathan Larson's musical loosely based on Giacomo Puccini's opera La Bohème. It won the 1996 Tony Award for Best Musical and the 1996 Pulitzer Prize for Drama. The story. In the late 1980s and early 1990s, friends in Manhattan's East Village struggled to build the lives of their dreams. Penniless, drug abuse, HIV/AIDS, social tension, and political unrest, among other hardships, challenged the group physically and emotionally. Facing the problems head on, they make personal self-discoveries and find what really matters most in life.
Rest.
in full disclosure, that was just a part of the song, because the song kind of overdoes, but quite effectively, the interval of the fifth. So I just wanted to present it to show that as a demonstration. Santi di sesta. Vacai's fifth piece is written around intervals of the sixth. The lyrics are from the opera Ezio, composed by Popora. The meter is in complex meter. The piece is written in the key of B flat major. As in the previous exercise, Vacai is economical in his use of text. Hyphenation is correct. The range, again, does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title Salti di sesta, or interval of the sixth. We'll sing that now. Here are examples of MT pieces composed around intervals of the sixth. We'll be doing Everybody Says Don't. Let's see, I think that's it. I don't know the rest of these, I'm so sorry. This is not like my thing. But we'll be doing Everybody Says Don't. This slide is organized in the same way as the first of its type, the Italian, the IPA, the solfege, and trying to put some words in there to make sense of it. The musical, Anyone Can Whistle, is a cult favorite. This Sondheim musical only played 9 performances in its initial run. The story, when Cora Hoover Hooper, the hated mayor of a small town, is faced with a town bankruptcy, she concocts a fake miracle to bring in tourism. Unfortunately, during the tourist rush, the inmates from the local asylum, the cookie jar, escape, and the lines between sanity and insanity quickly become blurred, much like my presentation. Although this song is sung by a male character in the musical, Barbra Streisand made it her own, thus giving us permission to own it as well. As soon as I take my water, everybody says don't.
Can't upset the clock, can't laugh at the clock.
Salti di settima. The Kai sixth piece is written around intervals of the seventh. The lyrics are from the opera Achille in Sciro, composed by Antonio Caldara. The meter is in common time. The piece is written in the key of C major. This interval is often difficult for the beginner to execute. Therefore, C major makes it just a little easier. As in the previous exercise, Vakai is economical in his use of text. Hyphenation is correct, range does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title. The only one I know from here is nothing, so we'll get to it. Oh, it's not working. Okay. Yeah. Wait, what? Okay. And there's that. So those are songs around the major seventh. Here's the example again, as in before, the Italian, the IPA, the solfege, and trying to incorporate nothing from a chorus line. You'll hear the interval, feel the motion, feel the motion. So you'll hear that kind of, it's kind of a hard one to get if you're not familiar with a seventh. A Chorus Line is one of the longest running shows of all time. This musical was formed from several taped workshop sessions with Broadway dancers. The story: the dancers auditioning for the chorus line of a new Broadway show are asked to tell the director about themselves in order to land a part.
Every day for a week we would try to
myself, and I tried to mend.
Maria, send me guidance, send me guidance on my knees. Went to church, praying, Santa Maria, help me feel it, help me feel it, pretty please. And a voice from down at the bottom of my soul came up to the top of my head. Yes, a voice from down at the bottom of my soul. Here is what it said. This man is nothing. This course is nothing. If you want something, go find a better class. And when you find one, you'll be an actress. And I assure you, that's what finally came to pass. 6 months later, I heard that Cobb had died. And I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and cried. 'Cause I felt nothing.
Sant'Idiottava. Vacai's seventh piece is written around intervals of the eighth. The lyrics are from the opera Alcide al Bivio, composed by Johann Adolf Hasse. The meter is in common time, however, the introduction of triplets and the accompaniment make the vocal rhythm a little more challenging. The piece is written in the key of C major, perhaps because of the rhythmic challenge to the singer. As in the previous exercise, Vacai is economical in his use of text. Hyphenation here is correct. Range does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title, Salti di Ottava. Here are examples of MT pieces composed around the octave. Bring him home from Les Miserables. Love never dies. I used to sing that when I was like, I don't know, 24, and then my voice went in the basement. Over the Rainbow, which we will be getting to momentarily. This slide is organized, again, in the way, the same of the first of its type, Italian, IPA, solfege, and an attempt of putting lyrics in from Somewhere Over the Rainbow. The Wizard of Oz is set in a Kansas farm, Munchkin Land, the road through the forest, the poppy field, the wizard's palace, and the borderland dividing the Kingdom of Oz from the dominions of the Good Witch. That I
like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where
Modo sincopato. The Kai's ninth piece is written around syncopation. The lyrics are from the dramatic piece Amor Prigioniero, composed by Georg Reuter. The meter is in 2-4. The accompaniment in the first two systems help to reinforce the feeling of syncopation. The piece is written in the key of G major. As in previous exercise, the Kai is economical in the use of text, hyphenation is correct, range does not go above the staff, and the piece is composed around the title, Modo Sincopato. Here are some examples of MT pieces composed around syncopated rhythm. There are a lot of them. We've already heard there's no business like show business. There is syncopation there. From the musical Girl Crazy, I got rhythm, I got music, and that's all I know. from Godspell, oh, bless the Lord my soul. We're actually, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't increase the size of that, but there are more. Miss Saigon, The Last Night of the World, Nick and Nora, Boom Chicka Boom, Old Man River, Stars for a New World from Songs for a New World by Jason Robert Brown, All American Prophet, Hasadiga, and You and Me, and But Mostly Me, those three from Book of Mormon. This slide is organized in the same way as the first of its type. Though it is not from a musical, it should be. Taylor the Latte Boy is a contemporary song by Marcy Heisler and Zena Goldrich. It is based on their experience with a barista at Starbucks. It is best known for being performed by Kristen Chenoweth on her album, As I Am. Taylor the Latte Boy tells the humorous tale of a woman who falls for her barista at Starbucks. Kristen Chenoweth says, I was a young Kristen Chenoweth doing Steel Pier at the time in 1997, and there was a performance honoring Kander and Ebb, a famous songwriting team, and someone handed me this music. Marcy and Zena told me they'd been writing the song with me in mind. I was so nervous because the show was the next day and it's not a short song. I spent the rest of the night learning it, and as I did, I realized this is totally me. I sang it that night and wow, did it go over.
There's a boy who works at Starbucks who is very inspirational. He is very inspirational because of many things. I walk in at 8:11 and he smiles and says, "How are you?" When he smiles and says, "How are you?" I could swear my heart grows wings. So today at 8:11, I decided I should meet him. I decided I should meet him in a proper, formal way. So today at 8:11, when he smiled and said, "How are you?" I said, "Fine, and my name's Kristen." And he softly answered, "Hey." And he said, "My name is Kristen. Taylor, which provides the inspiration for this poem. Taylor, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, Taylor, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. So I'd like to get my nerve up to recite my poem musical. He would like the fact it's musical because he plays guitar. Taylor told me he was playing in a band down in the village, in a band in the village, in the basement of our bar. And he smoothly flipped the lever to prepare my double latte, but for me he made a triple and he didn't think I knew. But he smoothly flipped the lever to prepare my double latte. But I knew that triple latte meant that Taylor loved me too. I said, "What time are you playing? And thank you for the extra skin." He said, "Keep the 355 because that triple latte was on him."
Editions of Vacai's Metodo Pratico di Canto Italiano per Camera diviso in 15 lezioni, ossiano solveggi progressivi ed elementari sopra parole di Metastasio, continue to be written and published nearly 200 years after the first publication. Vacai was a master educator. He saw the needs of the singer who did not want to be or want to sing opera. His method taught music theory to them, perhaps without them realizing they were learning music theory, to see and hear the difference between intervals. The vocal range and brevity of each exercise lends itself to mastering them to create a foundation for the CCM singer to return to over and over again, against which to check their technique. Hopefully you will agree with me that Vakai is just as much relevant today as he was in 1832. I thank you for your consideration. Acknowledgements. Oh boy. It takes a village to go through a program of higher education. I have so much gratitude for everyone listed here. Hopefully you'll be able to read them on the sheets. There are a lot. In one way or another, they supported my academic journey. 1 month before starting the graduate program, I had a medical emergency that produced a disability I will have for the remainder of my life. Though tempted to withdraw, I was met with nothing but support by the music faculty and NEIU Student Disability Services. Toward the end of my second semester, my mother died. The kindness and generosity given me by my professors and castmates in Suor Angelica and Gianni Schicchi overwhelms me more now than when the event occurred. Sorry. To my beloved friend and collaborative accompanist today, Paul Dykstra, with whom I have made music since the early 90s, you continue to enrich my life, and I adore you, and you know that. To my husband, who unfortunately couldn't be here today, who has seen everything from tragedy to ecstasy, and has been there through it all, I love you. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you all and hope you all get home safely. Thank you.